Good afternoon, students. So today we are going to learn about what is a magnetostriction effect. In previous lecture, we have learned about what are the properties of ultrasonic wave, then how this ultrasonic wave can be generated. So here, this ultrasonic wave can be generated by two ways. Okay. So first is your piezoelectric oscillator and second is your magnetostriction oscillator. We have learned up to this piezoelectric oscillator, and that is generation of ultrasonic wave by piezoelectric effect. Now we are going to learn how it is to be generated by magnetostriction oscillator, and this effect is your magnetostriction effect. So we will go to that slide. So what is magnetostriction effect? So magnetostriction effect means whenever a ferromagnetic material rod, that material should be of made of ferromagnetic material. That means it is of made up of alloy of nickel, cobalt, and different material. That is known as made up of different magnetic materials, magnetic, non-magnetic. So that is, it is of alloy, we can say that. Okay. So this is your ferromagnetic rod. When this ferromagnetic rod is placed in the magnetic field, so what we have to do is we have to make that magnetic material or magnetic rod magnetize and demagnetize. If this ferromagnetic material rod is magnetized and demagnetized, from its length it will get compressed and expand. So in this way it will get vibrate and it generates the frequency. So how many times it will get a vibrate? It will vibrate nearly 3 crore, you can take it 3 million times. Okay, 3 million times means nearly equal to the 3 lakh times. So 30 lakh times. So 30 lakh times it will get vibrate and elongated. So that due to that it will get in 1 second, so due to that it produced a very high frequency, and that frequency is your ultrasonic wave, generates your ultrasonic wave. So here you have to use the magnetic field, and by demagnetization and magnetization this ferromagnetic rod length will get changed, and due to that will produce the ultrasonic wave. So what is magnetostriction effect? When a bar of ferromagnetic material like iron or nickel is suddenly magnetized with the help of strong magnetic field applied parallel to its length. Here magnetic field is applied parallel to its length. There is a slight change in its length. What we have to do is we have to magnetize and demagnetize it. Then there is a slight change in length. So this effect is known as your magnetostriction. Striction means elongation, stretch karna usko, okay? So that's why it is known as the magnetostriction effect. So this is the circuit diagram for your magnetostriction oscillator. Here we have used the your transistor, okay, and this transistor is connected through this magnetic rod, through this inductor L1 and this varying capacitor C1, and this is your L2. So these two inductance and C1, these two forms the resonated circuit, okay, and this is connected to the base of this L2, is connected to the base of this transistor. And what happens due to this primary coil and secondary, this primary coil and secondary coil, there is a production of induced EMF. So this induced EMF gives the magnetic field, and due to that this rod will get this is the your ferromaterial rod. This rod will get compressed and elongated at very high frequency, at which frequency? 3 million hertz frequency, and there is a production of ultrasonic wave. So this is your magnetostriction oscillator. And what is the frequency of this oscillator? It depends upon these two, inductance of this L1 and this varying capacitor C1. So why this is varying? You have to vary the capacity of this capacitor. Arrow means it is varying capacitor. So that this frequency and this frequency both match with each other, and it is the condition for resonance. Okay, if these two frequencies are matches, then what happens? The rod will vibrate with the maximum frequency and it generates that ultrasonic wave. So This is about your magnetostriction oscillator. So what is the thing regarding magnetostriction oscillator is it can generate up to the 3 million hertz of frequency. It is economical and small in size, and this frequency generated by this rod is given by formula 1 upon twice t. T is the here I think L it is there. It is not T, actually it is the L. L is the length, so it should be replaced with the L, twice L it is there. What is L? L is equals to your length of the rod. You can take it as a L is equals to the, this is the length, L-E-N-G, it is the length of that magnet, ferromagnetic rod. Okay, so this is about your magnetostriction oscillator. If these two frequencies match with each other, then it will get resonance and it will vibrate with the maximum frequency. So this frequency or natural frequency will depends upon this Young's modulus of this material rod and its density of that ferromagnetic rod. This is the natural frequency and this is the frequency generated by the oscillators. But what are the disadvantage regarding this is, this is, it will get magnetized and demagnetized. So there is a production of heating effect. So this oscillation is depends upon the temperature, because if it is get heated, its temperature will go on. So after some time you cannot produce this oscillation due to the increase in temperature. Also it can produce the frequencies up to 3 million hertz. More than that it is not possible. If you have to produce the frequency more than 3 million hertz, you will use the piezoelectric oscillator. So this is about your magnetostriction oscillator and this is your magnetostriction effect. So when magnetic field is applied, so you know ferromagnetic rod magnetized and demagnetized, it will get compressed and expand. So this is about your piezoelectric oscillator. We have explained about this piezoelectric oscillator, generation of ultrasonic wave by these two oscillators and the properties of ultrasonic wave. So in this way, generation and properties part is over. And in next lecture, we are going to study how to detect the ultrasonic wave and their application. Okay, we'll stop here and